Okay, so our first step is to measure out the size of the hole that we need to cut on the side of our enclosed trailer for the window unit. So the easiest way for us to do this is to just go ahead, put it up there, take your Sharpie, and mark along the sides so that way it has a hole. So let's get started. Okay, so now that that's done, we're gonna go ahead and take our grinder and cut the hole for the window unit.
Thank you.
Now that we have cut all the way around, we are going to remove it and cut out all of the insulation and the pipe that is in the middle of it, so that way we'll have a clean hole to place in the weaning unit. All right, so just in case, we want to check, make sure that our hole is good for the window unit.
Dada!
Big enough. All right, so now that we know everything works good, we're gonna cut the bar out. Okay, so we want to make sure that we cut the correct holes from the outside. So we're gonna go ahead and take our drill gun, poke holes along our line that we need to drill and saw from the outside, so we have a good idea of where we're cutting.
I don't think I wanna cut the top, remember? I wanna kind of fold it.
All right, so now that we know where our holes are, we're going to cut the piece of metal out for it to sit really smooth. Okay, so now that we have it cut on the three sides, we're actually going to leave the top connected so that way we can wrap it over the AC unit and use it kind of as a shield from the rain. But what we're seeing right now is that it's actually glued to the pipe. So now we have to remove the metal from the pipe.
Heat gun. Use that knife.
Now that we got the metal off, we're gonna go ahead and finish cutting the pipe all the way through. Now it's time to put the window unit in.
Water won't run down in there. I mean, I'm gonna get some of that, press some of that grape stuff.
Now that we know that it fits good, we're gonna go ahead and level it out and drill our hole and put our nail in to that metal beam that's remaining. After we get that done, then we're gonna go ahead and put all of the caulk and the spaces in between so it's airtight.
Just gonna cut me.
Yes, we are using a broken fly swatter, but let's be honest, they're useful for so many things. You just need to get something that's sturdy enough for you to be able to push and small enough, skinny enough for you to really shove all of that foam around the unit. You want to get a really good airtight.
Something. Not sure quite yet what.
Mm-hmm.